Can human beings wipe out a species for good? It's wordplay. Hey Terminators, Julian here for DNews. When we talk about extinction, most of the time, it's a bad thing. Nobody celebrated when poaching drove the West African black rhino out of existence because they had done nothing to incur the wrath of humanity besides having a horn on their face. So have human beings ever caused an extinction that would make the most kind-hearted conservationist bust out the confetti and sing na 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 hey 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 goodbye? Has there ever been a good, intentional extinction? So far, it has happened. Exactly one time. In 1979, smallpox was officially declared eradicated. The disease was caused by the variola virus and existed for over 3,000 years. It caused raised red bumps that would fill with fluid that would turn into pus, and 30% of the people infected died. In the 20th century, it killed some 300 million people worldwide. Clearly, it was a bad mamma jamma, but thanks to an aggressive global vaccination campaign, it's been wiped out as far as we know, save for a few samples that exist in laboratories. So if people ever ask what good vaccines do, that. Nobody got all weepy-eyed when variola took a hike because it wasn't a valuable part of its ecosystem like other species we unintentionally wipe out. Smallpox only affected humans, so once it's gone, everybody wins. Well, except the virus. After smallpox, we've come close to eliminating a few other ailments, but we haven't gotten to 100% completion yet. The next closest species we've almost wiped out, intentionally, is the Guinea worm. The Guinea worm is a parasite that's terrible in almost every way. It enters its human host when they drink contaminated water. It drills out of their intestines and sets up shop in the abdominal muscles where it grows for a few months until it reaches sexual maturity. Then the males and the females mate. Yes, while still inside of a person, and the smaller male dies while the female, which can grow over a meter long, works its way down to the person's leg. After being inside of its human host for over a year, the female emerges from the leg or foot and releases an irritant that causes the wound to burn. It burns on and off for months, keeping the infected person from being able to work. The only way to soothe it is with water, so when the host sticks their leg in a stagnant pool, the mother worm vomits out her millions of embryos, and the whole process starts over again. Now, you may be thinking that if these embryos are in the water, there must be something that eats them, and you'd be right. They're often eaten by water fleas, but they aren't a valuable link in the food chain because they give the fleas the same treatment we get. The guinea worm burrows out of their digestive tract and munches on their insides while it waits for a human to swallow the flea. So everything about this worm is horrible, and there's no vaccine or drug that kills it. The only way to get rid of it is to cut it out or wait till it pokes its head out and then reel that sucker around a stick, drawing it free a couple of centimeters at a time over the course of weeks. Efforts to educate people about how it spreads and provide them with water filters have been spectacularly successful. There were over 3 million cases in 1980. In 2015, there were 22. And so far, in 2016, there have been just 12 cases. The fight's not over yet, as now the worms seem to have jumped to dogs to survive. But if the campaign to end guinea worms in dogs is as successful as it has been in humans, maybe in a couple of years, humanity will have wiped two species out. That we meant to, anyway. Can you imagine how long ago the guinea worm would have gone extinct if it had a valuable horn? Humans might be causing a mass extinction, but it's not the first. If you want a recap of the five previous times the Earth's slate was almost wiped clean, Trace has a video on it here.
Over the next 70 million years or so, these new conquerors of the Earth enjoyed their reign. Another 70%, though, would die in the late Devonian extinction, about 360 million years ago. This was mostly in the ocean, with coral and other shallow sea animals dying off. Hypothetically, they were hammered by the changes in sea levels, climate change, or perhaps an asteroid impact.
After the guinea worm, what's the next disease we should focus on to eliminate it forever? Malaria? I don't know. Tell us in the comments, subscribe for more, and we'll see you guys next time on DNews.